about CPE Bach and a birthday incident. You know much about him? It's one of his sons. How many sons did Bach have? Because women weren't composing those days. How many sons did he have who became really notable composers? Do you think of another one besides him? I'll put you on the spot. Did you Google this guy? It's pretty easy. Now, we used to have you a library to study. The other famous son is the London Bach. John Christian, took the English name, Christian Bach. He became the direct influence to Mozart. Mozart, at age 8, was in London, and he didn't take lessons from really anybody, but he listened, and John Christian would come to the house where the Mozarts were staying, and they had a game. Mozart would play 4 bars, he'd be sitting on his lap, because he was 8 years old, and John Christian would answer in 4 bars, and it would continue. So it's not because there was one person playing this piece, they improvised. But he learned that style, which was a new classical style. So CPE Bach encompasses that style. This piece reflects the classical style. It's late CPE Bach. It's a pre-classical, early classical piece. But he also wrote in a late Baroque style, and he wrote in a pre-romantic style. And I just played on the recital last night in San Francisco. A beautiful sonata, which he wrote at age 17, just after the family had moved to Leipzig from Köthen, where J.S. Bach had his new position as the Kapellmeister of the St. Thomas Church. And so, yeah, so he influenced the classical composers, he influenced the romantic composers. It's a very important composer. This is a very unusual piece by him, and it is so lighthearted and fun. You never heard of the first one?
I played it for a while ago.
Get into it, it's very beautiful also. Okay, are we two? No. Quarter note, you're playing an eighth note. And it sounds like you're out of breath. Da-da-da-da-da. Your drunkenness.
It is not the drunkenness, it's a full chord.
Great. Keep going. Do that in line. Other numbers?
Thank you.
keep playing tut instead of tut. But play ping pong. In answer, I go with this. Ground you in, and be richer and so on. Again, from. Or 17. Are you afraid to eat? Don't be afraid to eat. Crack it. Crack it, go ahead. Don't cry. Don't be afraid of it.
Okay.
Don't use this, use that. Don't cry. Don't use your pinky. If you're ill or nervous, just play the E this way. And it's a little flat, but it'll be fun. Somebody who smiles but has no teeth. I mean, it's rather crude, but it reveals something unbeautiful. You have to really know what you're doing when you're ornament. So many people, most people don't know what they're doing. They're just throwing all kinds of goulash. Now, an ornament comes out of the music, and it's in the style of the composer, and it takes a lot of study and knowledge to do it correctly.